Hello and welcome back to Accounting Stuff. I'm James and today I'll give you a quick and simple guide to using Xero. Let's get started. What is Xero? Xero is a cloud-based accounting software used by small businesses all over the world. It helps you do your bookkeeping. All you need is an internet connection and a device, like a laptop. Which version of Xero is right for you? If you scroll down to the video description, then you'll come across my affiliate links. There's one for the US and one for Canada. Both have three plans to choose from. In the US, they're called Early, Growing, and Established. You can try them out for free 30 days, or if you're raring to go, then you can sign up and get the discount right away. If you do that after clicking on my affiliate link, then I'll get a small commission which helps support this channel. Now, how about these three versions? The early plan is great for new businesses, sole traders, and the self-employed. It's the most affordable subscription at $15 per month, but it comes with its limitations. You can only raise 20 invoices and enter 5 bills per month. If that's not enough, then you can unlock more by signing up to the growing plan instead. This is a bit more pricey at $42 per month, but it also allows you to code transactions in bulk, which can be a big time saver. But growing is also lacking in some features. To get multiple currencies, job tracking, and expense claims, then you'll need the established plan, which costs $78 per month. If you're unsure, don't stress too hard about it. You can upgrade or downgrade. What does Xero look like? This is the Xero dashboard. You'll find your company name in the top left. Demo Company US is what we're using today. The big blue bar along the top is called the navigation bar. You can use this to get to your organization menu, the dashboard, and the business, accounting, payroll, projects, and contacts menus. In the top right, we have the create button, search, the notification bell, the help button, apps, and your user profile. We'll get onto all of these, but first, let's take a quick look at the dashboard. On the dashboard, we have some little summary boxes which highlight your key financials. You can see how your bank balances have changed over time, your total cash in and out by month, then there's your account watch list, a summary of the invoices owed to you and the bills that you need to pay, and expense claims. If you fancy a different layout, then you can click the Edit Dashboard button. This lets you move things around and hide stuff. How does Xero work? Let's make our way up to the nav bar and click on your company name. This brings up the organization menu. Under Files, you can upload and view important documents. And below that, you'll find your organization settings, which are divided into two columns. One for general and one for features. At the top of the general column, you'll find your organization details. Here you can update basic information about your business. You can add a logo, change your display name and legal trading name, add an industry, your organization type, your business registration number, employer identification number, and a short organization description. If we scroll down, then you can enter contact information like your postal and physical address, phone number, email, website, and social media links. When you're finished, click Save and we'll pop back into organization settings. Under Users, you can bring up a list of everyone who has access to your Xero file. You can invite new users, add Xero support, change permissions, and remove access as well. If you're on the established plan, you can go to currencies to add more, click add currency, select the one you want, and press the green button. Hey presto! In connected apps, you can add third-party apps to your Xero file. You can search for the app that you're after and click get this app if you want it. Back to settings and the features column. At the top, we have invoice settings. Here you can add your bank details and payment terms so that your customers know when and where to pay you. You can click branding themes to create your own invoice template from scratch, or make adjustments to the standard template to save time. You can preview your template to see what it looks like on a mobile or a desktop. If you want to give your customers more ways to pay you, then you can head to payment services. Here you can add new payment options to your invoices like cards, digital wallets like Apple Pay and Google Pay, direct debit, and PayPal. In email settings, you can tailor the emails that you send out from Xero. In expenses, you can adjust your expense claims and mileage claims. Check Styles lets you change the template for your checks. Xero to Xero lets you connect directly with other businesses who use Xero. And Custom Contact Links allows you to make shortcuts. Let's make our way back to the organization menu. Below settings, you'd normally find subscriptions and billing. We're in the demo company, so it's not there, but this would let you change or cancel your plan. Beneath that, you can access your different organizations in Xero if you have them, and add new ones. Then we have a list of add-ons. Gusto helps you do your payroll and tax filing. Then we have expense claims and Analytics Plus, which gives you some financial metrics and short-term cash flow projections. HubDoc, which can automate manual bookkeeping tasks like entering bills and receipts. And in the App Store, you can look for more plugins if you need them. At the bottom, we have a link to My Xero. Here you can get a summary of your different organizations and subscriptions. You can manage them here and change your billing details and account settings. Woohoo! That was the organization menu. Right, let me show you the Create button, which is this plus sign over here. We use this to create transactions. A new invoice, for example. You might want to raise one of these if you sell a product or a service to a customer. Filling out the form is dead simple. The customer's name goes here, then you can add the item that you sold, the quantity and the price. Then you need to pick the account that the sale should be recorded in, sales. Then you can select the tax rate, add a region or assign the sale to a project. And that's pretty much it. You can click here to preview the invoice and then approve and email to send it. The next thing you can create is a bill. You'll need this if a supplier has sent you an invoice with a due date, such as this one. When you fill in the information, the cost will be recorded as an expense in your business's income statement. And the liability, which you now owe, will be recorded as a bill to pay. When you're finished, hit approve. What else can we do in the Create menu? Well, we can create new contacts, quotes, and purchase orders. You can also create and post manual journals. If you don't know what these are, then I'd recommend talking to an accountant or a bookkeeper. You can learn all about manual journals on this channel, so if that interests you, why not click subscribe? Then we have spend money, which you can use to record cash payments, receive money for cash receipts, and transfer money for bank transfers. These three can all be created during the bank reconciliation as well, which I'll show you in a moment. Onwards! You can use the search function to find contacts and transactions. The notification bell lets you know about updates and deadlines. If you get fed up with them, then you can always turn them off in notification settings. The help menu lets you search for support articles. The app button gives you more links to add more apps. And then you have your user profile. You can use this to update your profile and account settings. Now, let's jump over to the business menu. It's here that you'll spend most of your time doing day-to-day tasks. If you've got Analytics Plus, then at the top you'll find a link to your short-term cash flow projection. This shows your projected cash balance for the next 30 days, along with the total of invoices owed to you and the bills you need to pay. Beneath that, we have the business snapshot. This gives you some handsome charts. There's sections on profitability, efficiency, financial position, and cash. Below Analytics, we have the sales section, which begins with invoices. This tab provides a summary of your business's sales invoices. You've got your invoice numbers, customers, due date, the amount due, and the status, so you can check to see if it's still awaiting payment. There's a button up here to turn on invoice reminders. Here you can set up some automatic emails that will be sent to your customers if they're overdue. If we move further down the business tab, then we have online payments, which allows you to add more online payment methods. Quotes can be used to send cost estimates to potential customers, and the sales dashboard, which outlines your invoices and quotes. We can see who owes you the most money and what's overdue. Red is bad. Beneath sales, we have purchases. Bills to pay is a detailed list of your bills. You can see who you owe money to, check the status, the due date, and the amount that you owe. Purchase orders gives you a list of, you guessed it, your purchase orders. You send them to suppliers and they outline what you want to buy, along with the agreed prices. You can set up an approval process to reduce the risk of unauthorized or incorrect orders. We also have a purchases overview, which looks similar to the sales overview. This one gives you a summary of your open bills and purchase orders. We have a chart, which shows what's owed and when, which we can pull out to see further into the future. Rightio! In the lower part of the business menu, you can record employee expense claims and manage checks. We also have products and services. This is an itemized list of the stuff that you sell. You can add more items by clicking the green button in the top right corner. Let's head on over to the accounting menu. This is the spot where you check your bank accounts, run reports, and mess around with advanced settings. We'll start with bank accounts. On the banking tab, you'll find your accounts that you've connected to Xero. In the demo company, we have a checking account showing its balance over time, and we have a savings account with no transactions. To add a new bank account, simply click on this button and follow the steps. Once connected, new transactions will be automatically imported into Xero through the live bank feed. Super handy indeed. When you're happy that all your transactions are flowing into Xero, it's wise to do regular bank reconciliations, at least once a month. This is where we match the transactions shown on your bank statement to the ones recorded in your books. This ensures that you have a complete and accurate record of them in Xero. Click on the Reconcile Items button to bring up the bank rec. There are two sides to this. On the left, you have the statement lines that feed in from your bank, and on the right, we match them to transactions recorded in Xero. As you can see, Xero tries its best to match them for you. Bless it. If you're satisfied with the match, then click OK to link the transactions together. Sadly, Xero won't be able to match all of them for you. But that's okay, we can do this manually without too much hassle. Pop in the customer or supplier name, choose the account that the transaction should be coded to, and enter a short description. You can also add more details, like a reference number, and attach a file to support the transaction. Save it and match it to your bank transaction, and rinse and repeat. If you find yourself coding similar transactions over and over, you can make a bankroll to speed things up. Now, let's have a quick look at reports. We've got a large selection included in Xero, which they've grouped together by type. Tax reports can be found near the bottom of the page, and if we make our way back up, then you'll find the OGs under financial statements. Of course, by that I mean the income statement, aka profit and loss, the balance sheet, and the cash flow statement. You can add them as favorites by clicking on the little star. The income statement shows your business's financial performance. It's a summary of your revenues and expenses over a period of time. We can find your other favorite reports on the accounting menu. The balance sheet is a snapshot of your financial position. It lays out your assets, liabilities, and equity at a point in time. Then there's the cash flow statement, which summarizes your cash inflows and outflows over a period of time. Which brings us on to advanced accounting. I wouldn't recommend messing with it unless you know what you're doing. But there are some handy features that let you find and recode transactions, post manual journals, and access your fixed asset register. Your business's chart of accounts also lives here. It's a complete list of all your accounts. Make sure you work with an accountant or bookkeeper to set this up correctly. If you're using payroll, then you'd see a tab for that here. Projects can be used to track time and costs by job. There's a list of all your projects which you can click on to track completion by time or amount invoiced. Contacts are used to organize the people and businesses you interact with. There's a complete list of all your contacts with columns showing what you owe and what they owe. You can add a new contact by clicking the green button. There you go. If you're keen to give Xero a try, then I'd appreciate it if you used my affiliate link in the description. What other accounting software would you like to see on this channel? Please do let me know in the comments, and I'll see you next time.